I'm Daniel Shelley.
And I'm Taylor Niven. And you're watching
Talk of the Town. Thanks for watching this episode of Talk of the Town.
You're on campus source for entertainment news.
Now, if you thought the fight between the Democrats and the Republicans was bad, wait till you find out who's fighting in the Twitterverse. Brittany and Alicia battle it out in gossip.
After that, Mina takes us around on campus to find out what you're doing for fall break and man on the street.
Okay, I don't know the lyrics. Yeah, it's okay. It's cool. We just want to get to it. Hello! This is episode 2 of Talk of the Town, the gossip segment. We do have the lovely Alisa Holmes here for my first episode of gossip. Yay! And I'm so excited. We have so much to talk about, okay? So let's get right into the tea. The first person we're going to talk about is Rihanna, okay? So she just came out with her new music video, Pour It Up. Now, the song is a year old, but the video has just come out. If you know the song, then you know what the song is pretty much about. It's about strippers, okay? So basically, she's saying that this is supposed to be really artistic. You know, it's supposed to show how dancers have a good time, and you're in the club, and you're making it rain.
What do you think? I mean, I watched the video. About 1 minute into the video, I paused. I couldn't look at it anymore. I don't know what Rihanna was thinking when she made this video.
So speaking of Rihanna, okay, now we all know that Rihanna has no shame in her game when it comes to speaking her mind on Twitter. Although I'd like to see if she could really talk that talk,
yeah,
and walk that walk. Because I've never seen her get into it with someone personally. It's always been behind the laptop.
Yeah.
So apparently, she has a Twitter beef going on with this girl named Teyana Taylor. Apparently, Teyana Taylor came out on Instagram with this video. She was singing this song, Caught Up in the Rapture. Rihanna, obviously, like, shot fire at her by coming up with another Instagram video. And so basically she had this old ugly guy dressed up in this curly wig. It was a really like ugly wig.
Yes.
And had on the lipstick, basically dressed up like Teyana Taylor, and had him singing just like her.
Yeah.
And Teyana Taylor was so mad. Rihanna dressed up like her. And Teyana was like, how are you just being yourself when you're dressed like me? You're trying to look like me. And the weird thing about it is that they used to be friends.
Yes, I have seen so many pictures of them together.
I don't even understand that. Well, you know, Teyana feels like Rihanna is just a downright bully, okay? And she feels like, well, she had a lot to say on Twitter. For instance, I'll read some to you. Teyana was like, don't play with me, Rihanna. F this industry-ish. You and I know each other very well. You have my number, so don't show off. Y'all can bully everyone else and get away with it, but that ish ain't gonna work over here. So y'all miss me with that Navy-ish. Rihanna Robin never been about that life. And Twitter went overboard, okay? I was like, when I saw some of the people's tweets, and some of you game-caught tweeters, when I saw some of your tweets, I was like, did they get into, like, a physical fight? Like, I really thought it was a physical fight. But when I went on the Twitters, like, they were just going back and forth with
yes.
the tweets. And I was like, Twitter, you are going overboard. Like, you guys would kill for some juicy drama. Is it that serious? Is it that serious? If there was a physical fight, who would win the fight?
Teyana Taylor is like fitness, like guru. She has all these fitness videos on YouTube. She's a dancer,
yes.
A professional dancer.
Yeah, she's cut. She's
yes.
fit.
Rihanna's not that agile. I'm thinking Teyana Taylor would wipe the floor with Rihanna.
Right.
Like
now, I think Rihanna won the Twitter fight because she really did get down up under Teyana's skin. Like, she really made her mad. She did exactly what she aimed to do. And
yeah.
that was to really tick her off. But you're right. I really think Teyana would win that fight. To give Rihanna some credit. She is an island girl. You know, she's from the Barbados. But you know, Rihanna smokes a lot, and she drinks a lot, and she likes to turn up a lot. So I think if she would win the fight, it's because she would probably throw a bottle or something, but not because she actually, like, used her hands to fight, you know? Until next time, this is Gossip. See ya.
I'm Mita Mooney, and this is Man on the Street. I'm standing outside of Russell House wondering what you're going to be doing for fall break.
I'm going on a retreat with First Baptist, and we're going to Gatlinburg to see the USC versus UT.
I'm probably going to stay in Columbia and hang out with friends and probably catch up with some work to get prepared for the week after.
I'm going back home to lovely Philadelphia to visit my family and enjoy a nice Philly cheesesteak and see my little sisters.
I'm doing research for a book I'm writing about Mount Vernon, at Mount Vernon, on the history of the building and its kind of role in American culture.
Well, for fall break, I'm going to Georgia to visit my family, and then we're just going to hang out with them and have fun. It's been a minute.
Nothing. Probably going to be here for fall break. No plans. Mm-hmm. Staying at Bates' house.
I'm going back home to Parkton, Maryland. Oh, and I'm going apple picking. In the orchards.
Probably just work. I work at a restaurant, San Jose in Blythewood, so work most of the time, I believe.
And for me, I'm going to Charleston to visit my boyfriend and hang out on the beach. That's it for Man on the Street.
Coming up, we have Highscore Headquarters. Welcome back to Talk of the Town.
On this week's Highscore Headquarters, Ryan, Khadija, and Tang get a little competitive with their video game.
So last time I talked a little bit about Grand Theft Auto Online and I made a joke about how it was going to break the internet. Well, it turns out I was kind of right. Well, it didn't actually break the internet. It was really, really glitchy. People had trouble getting on. It was really, really slow. But that's what you would expect when tens of thousands of people are logging on at the same time for the first time. So if we give it maybe 2 weeks, Rockstar will probably have it sorted out.
So Valve decided to make three big announcements this week, teasing the entire thing with a giant purple spear and three weird symbols. The first of which was their new Steam operating system. It's a Linux-based system that is designed to bring the PC to your living room. Hundreds of new games will be coming to the operating system, and new titles will be announced in the oncoming weeks. And if you're worried about Steam games not being able to be played on the operating system, you can stream any games from your Mac or PC to your living room TV, which is great. The second thing that Valve announced this week was the Steam Machine, which will be a new console that they will distribute to 300 lucky Steam users for a hardware beta test. If you apply before October 25th and fulfill the first five requirements that they've made so far, the first being join the Steam Universe community group, second, agree to the Steam hardware beta terms and conditions, three, make 10 Steam friends if you haven't already, four, create a public Steam community profile, and five, play a game using a gamepad in big picture mode. You can qualify and maybe, just maybe, get a Steam box. And the third announcement this week is not Half-Life 3. It is the announcement of a new Steam controller, which replaces the usual analog sticks with two haptic trackpads that should sense amplitude, frequency, and is controlled by voodoo magic or some, I don't know. But it's gonna revolutionize everything. It's also made to be hackable by the Steam community and the community workshops and everything, so you can add new software and hardware and do pretty much whatever you want with it. Whatever.
Pokemon X and Y debuts October 12th. This game features a new twist, a new generation of fairy characters, which will totally change the gameplay forever. In addition to the new fairy characters, the three original starter Pokemon, Charizard, Blastoise, and Venusaur, have evolved.
Which is stupid.
I wish I could say that this game has new features, but it's really not. It's 3D, it's in the same world that it's always been for Pokemon, so hopefully, as the game goes on, that people will actually enjoy what the gameplay has to offer.
So we recently learned about a new club on campus called Esports, so we decided to go check them out.
I started Esports Club back in November of last year. It started as me and a couple of friends just thinking about it, talking about other esports clubs that were going on. We would watch some online streams about some video games that we played. we thought to ourselves, hey, we could actually do this here. And so we decided to go. We stopped by the Office of Student Affairs and figured out what was going on and how we could actually create a club. We probably only had about 20 members going into Christmas last year. And then by the end of the spring semester this year, we had probably around 100. And now, a few months into this fall semester, we've gotten up to about 220 people. We have a League of Legends section, we have a StarCraft section, we have a Dota section, we have a console gaming section, and we have a Minecraft section, and then we also have a Magic division. Magic the Gathering is actually a card game. It's not exactly esports, but we kind of adopted them because we had a lot of members who played Magic. Since we're a large group of people in a very small area, we can do some things that other people can't do. Like we can have big in-house, sitting right next to the people you're playing video games with events like this that you really can't do anywhere else. And that's what esports is. It's really a social club about this thing that interests so many people. We have a Facebook that's South Carolina Esports, www.facebook.com/SC Esports. We have a Twitter, which is just South Carolina Esports. We have several other Facebook pages for specific games that you'll be routed to once you actually go to our original Facebook. SCEsports.boards.net, www.SCEsports.boards.net. We have our own forum. We have a place where you can go and keep up with a calendar that shows all of our events that will be coming up. We have kind of the about of the leadership team. And if you want to come out to events and things, check out our website and they'll have the times for all the events that we do. We don't have regular meetings right now just because how big the club is and how many different interests we have. But if you are looking to get involved, then do go to our website and check out some of the calendar events that we have planned and show up and we'll take care of it from there.
All right, guys, make sure you go online, check out esports and show them some support.
And that's all that we have for you guys. Join us next week for more gaming awesomeness.
Also Twitter.
Coming up, we have Press Pass and USC Lady Code. Welcome back to Talk of the Town.
In this week's Press Pass, I sat down with the cast of Girl and Guy Code when they came to the Russell House through Carolina Productions. I found out some tips that may help you survive your time here at USC.
And we became so inspired after meeting the cast of Girl and Guy Code that we created our own version called USC Lady Code. Check it out.
I'm dropping out of college. I'm going to drop out of college.
I like being downy because I can say y'all and people don't accuse me of acting black.
There you go. Don't go broke trying to impress broke people. That's real talk.
That was.
Thank you. I mean, you know, these are my mantras. Typically, get a round of applause because they're that profound.
Right. Never trust a big button smile.
Oh.
That is
there you go. That's
deep. That's deep.
Yeah, if you want to see that, sooner kill him.
Mines don't get pregnant still.
Don't get Carly pregnant.
Right.
How do I make a walk of shame classy? I put on a prom dress.
There you go.
I put on a classic ball gown.
Mm.
At home.
Yeah.
With the frippy shoulders.
Yeah.
Really?
That's good. That's really good.
Sex with the Great Gatsby.
I think always have extra pair of shoes in your bag that are flats. And then if you are at a guy's house, you need to take his clothes, put them on, and then do your walk. So it's like this girl's athletic.
Mm. Deep.
Genius.
That.
It's genius.
Nah,
it's very smart. It's very
profound.
Smart.
Profound.
Or this girl's a lesbian. That's what else it could do.
Right, but would you rather be a lesbian or like a huge slut?
I'd rather be an athletic lesbian.
Be what you want to be, kids.
I view myself as an athletic lesbian.
I would just class it up. I'd use a Segway and a cape. So it looks like I'm making a good getaway.
While there are no walks of shame for men, it's a walk of pride unless she's uggers and follows you down the street.
Uggers?
Uggers. Uggers is real though.
Is that like a new boo? You think uggers?
Uggers.
Yeah, I don't know.
Uggers.
Uggers. I don't have time to say uggers.
Uggers. Right. Uggers. I really like uggers. Mm-hmm. I shave my stomach.
I want to put my in the air blade. Don't judge me.
Up until 3 months ago, my mom rubbed cream over the dry skin of my nipples, but now Carly does it. Don't judge me.
My dog is so compact that when I try to rub his belly, I him up a little.
There you go. Don't judge that man.
Drinking rules, stick to daiquiris.
Mm-hmm.
So I am. Yeah. I'm not ashamed of it.
Are you serious?
Yes.
He's not kidding.
Have a glass of water between each drink, just so that paces you and then you don't throw up. Trust me, keeps you hydrated, you don't pass out.
Don't throw up out of your nose.
Mmm, that's good.
Don't throw up out of your nose.
Feel every drink, don't pound.
Mmm,
that's good advice.
Let it work, it's magic.
That's some good shit to say as you get drunk. Do you feel that? Woo! Feel it!
Not only is it economical, but you know, you might save yourself from a night in the rubber tank.
I just crash a party, open the door. If someone says you're not invited to this party, just punch them in the face.
There you go.
Perfect.
That's it.
Brooklyn style.
Oh, you just walk up in that spot like you've invited. You just, yeah. You hell yeah. You say, yo, I'm here.
Yeah.
And that's it.
You do a lot of these.
Make an entrance. Yeah.
Just BC, be cool, MVP, bring booze. Because if you bring a jug of something.
I was going to say that, yeah. That's it.
You're not invited. Oh, yeah, well, I'm leaving. With my jug of booze. No. Come right in, sit right down.
There you go.
Hang out.
There you go.
Strangers are just friends you haven't made yet.
Just be like this. Hey, you left all your shit at my house.
Yeah.
And I came to give it back to you. So you're welcome. And
there you
I
go.
Didn't know that you were having a party. Did you forget to invite me? And then she'll be like, no, I didn't forget to invite you. I just didn't invite you. And you're like, well, I returned all your stuff.
Mm.
And then she's like, what stuff? And you're like, I stole a bunch of your stuff and I'm going to leave now.
What's up, ladies? We're here to talk about the dirty, ugly, and fantastic, always classy truth about life as a Gamecock. It's USC Lady Code. On this episode of Lady Code, grab your little black dress and solo cup. We're talking game days.
All my friends left me. I don't know where the stadium is. Well, bitch, it's the big-ass building right there.
It's game day. It's what's to be expected.
Also, don't hog that mirror, because we're sharing bathrooms.
Keep your shit on this side, I'll keep my shit on this side, and you know, at some point, somebody cleans the toilet.
Do you not need your toothbrush every day? Because it's on the floor, all right? Do you not need to pick up your tampon? Because it's on the floor. Then, you might not always know his last name, but there's no shame. We're talking college hookups.
Oh man, college hookups.
Living in a dorm, you experience many different things, even if you aren't in the world having sex. So, maybe you have some neighbors that like to get their freak on during the day. Take a broom like we did and just bang it until they stop banging.
Girls that go too hard on game day, they probably shouldn't be wearing their short dresses. Here's the thing, if you don't want every fraternity man at the University of South Carolina seeing your lady parts, you probably shouldn't drink a fifth of Jack before you walk into the game. You're gonna pass out in the parking lot, and then the whole world's gonna know what you have. And that's never classy.
There's a lot of cowgirl boots. Lots and lots of drinking.
You have to make sure you prep yourself, because it's gonna be hot. This is Columbia. It is burning outside, and you don't wanna be drinking too much in that hot heat. It is not okay. You're gonna be that girl laying in the bleachers, passed out, having to go to the hospital because you drank too much in the heat. This is Columbia. You need to pace yourself. I don't care if you double fist it with a water bottle. Make it happen because you gotta look classy.
The advice that I could give is you're gonna be jumping up and down on the bleachers for 4 hours. Don't wear anything that you don't want to jump up and down on bleachers, like around your younger brother's high school friends, because it's just not good.
Gotta wear a black dress or a garnet dress. I mean, South Carolina, gotta wear a garnet and boots. You gotta do it. It's the law. It's the South. If you do become that girl that is just in there crying her eyes out on the sidewalk, there's always gonna be some nice person to either help you get to the stadium or help get you back to your apartment or dorm. Man, it's the South. We're all gentlemen here.
Find a ride to the game. We get down there, we party hard, go inside, and then maybe around halftime, it's time to go.
Ladies, the number one rule about your bathroom is keep that shit clean.
There's tampons everywhere. There's tissue on the floor. People running the water while they poop. Who runs the water while you poop? No one cares. We all poop.
just turn the music on like I do, and then no one cares about you pooping because they're too busy listening to the music that you're listening to. So it doesn't even matter.
For sharing a bathroom, don't buy expensive shampoo. And if you do, take it in a shower caddy. You know, they're cute. You can get a colorful one. Take it out of the bathroom. Because if you leave your expensive hair care products in the bathroom, somebody's gonna use them. I mean, my sweet mate had some nice Tresemme stuff. Yeah, it worked for my hair pretty well.
Oh my God, the showers. The showers are never fully functional. They're always clogged up with someone's hair. I mean, look at this. This doesn't need to be washed every day. So if there's hair in the shower, I pick up my own hair. Pick up your own hair. Why do you think it's okay to do these things?
Keep your shit on this side. I'll keep my shit on this side.
If you're gonna hook up with someone and you're gonna do it with someone you met in Five Points, don't do it with someone you met at PAVS.
Here's the thing. If you're leaving with a girl, it really depends on if you wanna see that girl again. Because if you don't, you never take her back to your house. Because then she's gonna know where you live. If she's one of those creepy stalker girls, she's gonna show up every 5 minutes asking when you're gonna hang out again. So guys, if you really, really wanna take a girl home, go back to her place. Have your fun there. And then that's the end of it. Ladies, that's your first sign that he doesn't want to see you again. Take note.
Rule number one, know his last name before you get in his bed. Please, all right? If you don't know his last name, at least know his first name. And at least try and make sure the first name is the real name and not a fake name.
If you're lucky enough to have a guy stay the night with you, he might be a little bit interested. If he leaves somewhere around 3 a.m. while you're cuddling with your body pillow, chances are you're never gonna see him again. You're not gonna remember his name because he probably didn't tell you the right one anyway.
But if you go back to your place, there's a couple different rules here. Expect to get it in the morning for a second time.
Don't hook up with anyone who goes to USC because you are going to see them in the Russell House on Chicken Finger Wednesday and he's gonna look at you and he's gonna remember. And you're both gonna remember and you're gonna be mortified. Do Air Force. There's an Air Force base nearby. They're always in Five Points. Just get a scene check. Find out where they're from and then make your decision based off of that. Don't do it with anyone you're gonna see again because you don't want that in your life.
Don't fall in love with your college hookup, okay? Don't be texting him the next morning. Don't be thinking y'all are gonna hang out again.
I know we're in college. I know it's the time for you to do whatever you want, get your freak on, get your nasty on, do whatever.
This is college, let's be real. These guys are not looking to fall in love. They're not looking to get married. You need to look to have a good time and only a good time.
I only had two rules. These two rules were, don't kiss anybody you don't know and don't black out. Did they ever follow the rules? Of course not, but they always came home safe. So, college hookups, be safe. Even if you're not gonna follow the rules that I give you.
Thanks for watching this episode of Talk of the Town.
Check out the Halloween edition of Talk of the Town airing October 30th.
We'll see you next time.